Exclamation, everybody, and welcome back to Star Trek Online. So when we last left off, we got a thing from Daniels, just out of the blue, about Vorgon conclusions, where we have to go to the Laris system. But we also have the main quests here with Desperate Measures, which is what we're going to start here first. And off camera, I was doing the, you know, normal R&D stuff, and a Klingon from Deep Space Nine contacted me and was like, "Hey, I've taken notice to you. Why don't you come in and come find me? I got stuff for you to do." So we might do that at some point along here too. Also, I've got skills to pay the bills. So let's see what I will spend my space point on. I could do it on, more resistance. Be interesting. Or we could do advanced impulse expertise. Turn rate, speed and turn rate would be really good. Full impulse energy shunt, improved EPS flow. Perhaps we'll do that one. That sounds like a decent one. There's also damage control, which I probably should do at some point too. But anyway, we'll purchase that. There we go. Now provide training and emergency power to weapons 3 as needed. All right, so, and then we've still got a ton of things. Like I have not even gotten into the captain or the admiral traits yet or anything like that. So hopefully we'll be able to get all the way down there because I'm at level 44 and I think it caps off at level 60, I think. So it doesn't look like I'm going to be able to get into all the admiral traits yet. I could get into them now. I'm wondering if I should do that, you know, just jump ahead on those. Well, we'll see. We will see as we do it. Ultimate enhancers and stuff here. Okay. Let's begin Desperate Measures. Captain, we have the Borg sphere on sensors. There are multiple Romulan patrols in the area, sir. We will need to deal with them before we can scuttle the sphere. Engage the Romulan patrols. Ray shield and set a course for the closest Romulan ship. Alright, let's do this. More Romulans to deal with. We also have a few anomalies in the area. So we got an enemy up here, a light warbird. Let's see if that's the only one we have to deal with as we get in closer. Alright, let's do our thing. Do it. Take his shields down and take him to the bank. go ape on him. All those things. Alright, torpedoes. All his shields are down. And hit from the back here. Not ideal. Just keep moving. Keep juking and jiving. Oh, that's gonna hurt. That's gonna hurt a lot. There we go, we got that. And these guys here with their damn torpedoes. Gotta do something about them. They're giving me a bad name here. Let's give them a whole barrage of torpedoes, shall we? See how they like that. Didn't seem to like it too much. Alright, and... Yes! More torpedoes, you say? I give you more torpedoes, then. That is the soup of the day, is torpedoes. Hope you like them. Okay, and let's get around this way, shall we? Take this guy's shields down. And give him a little welcoming party. Have a spread of torpedoes. How does that taste? You like my torpedo stew? Okay, that was kind of a wasted thing that I did, but oh well. I keep these guys in front of me as much as I can. Oh, what the? My ship suddenly went. The camera moved away from my ship. It's like, wait, oops. Gotta keep you in frame. That's right. That's how this works. Yeah, this guy ain't no thing. Just keep shooting his unshielded parts. There we go. Romulan reinforcements warping in. Okay, we got a heavy warbird. These guys suck. Big time. Dealing with them. Dealing with them sucks. A whole lot. Let's see if I can give him a rude awakening, shall we? Wow, my shields. What is going on here? Do a little miracle worker on him. He's got those freaking transporter things. I hate those things. I hate them so much. So freaking much. They are so cheaty. So goddamn cheaty. I hate them. Because what happens is they just spam them. The computer does, that is. It just spams them, and then you can't do a damn thing about them. And let's see if I can get rid of them this way. There, that got rid of them. All right, let's see if we can take this. Oh, he freaking deployed more of them. God damn this guy. That's why these Romulan warbirds are so freaking cheaty. Big freaking cheaters, I tell you. Big freaking cheaters. Every one of them. Every single one of them. Finally killed that guy. Holy hell. Killed me about 4 times, I think. Because of those damn freaking cloaking mines. Those tractor beam mines that just suck all your energy out. Those damn things. I remember those from the last time I played this. Man, they suck so bad. They are so freaking cheaty. It is unbelievable. I say. Unbelievable. Let's get this hydrazine gas. I think I have some repairs I can make to the ship here. Some repair things. So we'll do that. Let's see if I have any. I think I do. Let's see. Repair all. There we go. That works. Alright. So we repaired that damage. And here's the Borg sphere. We were here to retrieve. Is this where I'm supposed to go, or am I supposed to go to... Oh, nope. Scan the Borg sphere. All right. I'm not picking up any signs of Romulan ships, and there is no life signs on the sphere. Recommend we destroy it now. All right. Arm weapons. Let's do this. Well, that was really easy. Shockingly easy. We one shot at that guy. Captain, our top priority should be to find any technology or research the Romulans may have salvaged already. There is a Romulan communication satellite in this area. If we program it to transmit an emergency signal, the Romulans will send a ship here to investigate. We can hide behind that asteroid. If we run minimal power, the mineral content in it should disrupt sensor readings. Once that patrol vessel arrives, we can use a reconfigured Class 2 probe to essentially tag the Romulan ship. Even if they cloak, we'll be able to follow the probe's energy signature. If there is a base anywhere in the region, we'll find it. Alright, reconfigure the communication satellite. The one I just saw over here. Yep. Yep, indeed. Indeed that one. Let's get on over there then. Shall we? And do our reconfiguring. Excellent, now we just need a place to hide. If we fly behind that asteroid and power down our systems, I think we should be able to avoid detection. I'll fly behind the asteroid and power down systems. Okay. I'm gonna wait for the Romulan ship. We've got a helpful countdown here. And observe. There we go. There. We've tied the vessel with a subspace transmitter, sir. We should be able to follow it at warp speed. Okay. So am I supposed to follow it now? They are scanning the wreckage of the Borg sphere, sir. I hope they don't find anything useful. The ship has gone to warp, sir. Based on telemetry from the probe, I believe they are traveling to the Gasco system. There's a small colony on the space station there. Laying in a course for Gasco, sir. We can leave as soon as you're ready. Alright, let's just leave now. I don't feel like getting any other resources from this realm, from this area. We have arrived in the Gasco system, sir. Scans confirm Borg technology on the station. They have detected us, sir. They are launching several ships, and they have activated their defenses. We have the element of surprise on our side for the moment, but they are bound to call on reinforcements. Recommend we eliminate resistance and beam down to the station as quickly as possible. Agreed. Well, we're certainly going to try, but we're not going to be very good at it, I don't think. Especially with these... especially with the heavy warbird being as keen in the neck that they are. Alright, finally picked off all those people and all the turrets. It only took about 6 or 7 deaths to do it. But yes, I am ready to beam down. And I will accept the defaults here. Man, oh man. I should have trained my crew to be able to undo tractor beams, because man, are the Romulans terrible at tractor beams. Sir, we have arrived in the Gasco Station. The station is on high alert. We should expect heavy resistance. Normally, Starfleet attempts to resolve conflicts peacefully, but in this case, the security of the Quadrant requires an armed response. We should interrogate any scientists we find along the way and determine where the Borg research is located. Right, defeat guards and interrogate scientists. Let's do this. We have a scientist right here. It looks like she's in desperate need of interrogation. So let's do that, shall we?
Starfleet? What are you doing here?
We have traced Borg technology back to the station. We intend to destroy it.
Really? I sympathize. That Borg technology is creepy. We all hate it, but we don't have any choice but to work for the Tal Shiar. They're holding my sister hostage to make sure I behave, and she's not the only one.
Well, I'll do what I can to help her.
You might need help yourself in a minute or two. Your transport was detected, and the station is on high alert. Security forces are already on their way. You don't have a chance.
We have no choice. We need to stop what's happening here.
Promise you'll try to help my sister, and I'll unlock all the doors and turbo lifts for you. There, she's near the medical bay. Good luck, and don't forget my sister.
We'll get her out. Don't you worry. Don't you worry about thing. We got this. Sort of. Oh wow, that's a lot of Romulans. Hey guys, how you doing? I'm gonna go back here for a little bit. Yikes. Alright. Oh good, they put a shield thing down. Oh, and some health. Excellent. Excellent, Smithers. Thank you for that health. I should just rename you Smithers. Cause you know right what I need when I need it. There we go. Alright. Take all the items. Yep, take the medium hypo, sure, why not? We'll move along. Is that Gasco colonist? Oh, nope, here's some Centurions coming. I was gonna say, is he friend or foe? Wow, they're beaming a whole lot of people in, it looks like. Jeez. Unless I'm seeing things. It's hardly possible that I'm seeing things. That guy's still not dead. Holy hell, how many times do I gotta shoot this guy for him to go down? Hello? You gonna fire? What are you doing? What are you doing here? My guy has stopped firing for some reason. Am I in like a stasis field or something? What's going on here? Alright, let's see what he has to say for himself. Oh, nothing. He has nothing to say for himself, alright. Let's go get some health if I need it. There we go. Everybody gets a little bit of health. And these guys, another double shift. He's complaining about... There was a firefight in front of your door and you're complaining about pulling a double shift? I think your priorities are wrong. Talk to head researcher.
You! Are you from Starfleet?
I could ask you the same thing.
I have no love for the Tal Shiar, but I do have a family. If I complete my work, the Tal Shiar will guarantee our safety.
Perhaps we can rescue them. Where are they located?
Most of the families are being held in the medical lab. You'll need to cross the engineering level to get there. Be careful. Some of what they're working on there is quite dangerous.
You don't say.
Any use of Borg technology is dangerous. You're talking about devices designed to regenerate damage, replicate themselves, and assimilate anything they can reach. If we had a breach in containment, we could lose the station and everyone in it.
Well, thanks. We'll do what we can for your family. Which is to say, probably not much, but, you know, as long as they're not Borgified, you're good. If they are Borgified, well, sorry. I did my best. Another colonist just kind of sitting there, too. That door looks like it's not one that you can walk through. Console down there. I guess this is the turbo lift, huh? Yep, turbo lift engineering. There they are. Who? Who's where? Who's where you think you are? This is certainly not me. So let us do that. Access research logs. Research log 1. Head researcher log supplemental. The Hirogen upheld their end of the bargain and delivered a disabled Borg sphere to the Palladus system. As a precaution, we have not moved the sphere from that location. I do not want to risk powering any systems that might trigger the Borg's regeneration protocols. However, I do feel it is safe to begin dismantling and analyzing the sphere's components. The Borg technology shows great promise. I believe we will be able to improve our weapons and shield technology well within the Empress's timeline. Head Researcher's Log Supplemental. Work to integrate Borg components into our vessels has begun. So far, the process is proceeding as expected. We have increased the combat capabilities of our ships by upwards of 30%, and I still feel like we are barely scratching the surface. There's so much about the Borg technology I do not understand. Some of my researchers have expressed concerns over the risks of experimenting with this technology. I explain that circumstances beyond our control force us to take extreme measures. I suspect they continue to have misgivings, but they no longer share them with me. Head Researcher's Log Supplemental. I now share my staff's misgivings about this line of research. Incorporating Borg technology into our ships is one thing, but this Commander Nevek has taken over our medical bay and is experimenting with incorporating Borg technology into our citizens. Yep, I told you. All your families are Borgified, probably. Anybody that expresses discontent with the program either disappears or finds their family being held hostage to ensure their cooperation. We should have never sided with the Tal Shiar, and now it's too late. Alright, well, that, yeah. Sudden realization. Destroy Borg research. Let's do it. Well, that was taken care of in spectacular fashion. And now what? Collins is just kind of hanging around like, yes, thank you for doing that. Yeah, all right, I like this. I can just walk around and just destroy all the things. Okay, that's apparently not Borg. There we go. Come on, shoot him before he shoots me. Excellent. Now some health. Some health would be really nice right now. Really, really nice. Okay. It was a good positioning of that medical generator by my peeps. Alright. And we're all healed up, but all my other peeps are unconscious, so let's go help them. Come on, get up and get some healing freshness here. Everything will be just fine. Just come on over here. There you go. Yeah, just stand in there for a little bit. You'll be cool. You'll be alright as rain in just a moment. You know, I'm just waiting for their bars to go fully green. There we go. Excellent. Alright, we took down their commander. The cheese ball way, but it's done. Let's take that. And we'll take that. And we'll unlock the cells. Go. Alright. Everybody out.
I can't even begin to express my gratitude. I'm from Serini Prime, one of the colonies that is still neutral in the conflict between the Republic and the Tal Shiar. Before all this, I was a vocal proponent for the Republic. All I can think is that I attracted the wrong kind of attention for my outspoken beliefs.
Whatever do you mean?
One day I went for a walk on the cliffs near my settlement. I remember seeing something strange and hearing a metallic buzzing. Then everything went black. I woke up in this cell. No one will tell me where I am or why I'm here. What they do say is that I'm a test subject. They're planning on implanting me with Borg technology. I didn't think anyone could be so callous. Not even the Tal Shiar.
We'll get you home. Cortex, one to beam up. And you? How could they experiment on their own people, he says. Well, you're going to go beam away. So good luck to you. Rescue this subject. Her head hurts. Well, hey, you know what? At least it's just your head and not your entire freaking body like this guy. This guy is a little too far gone, I'd say. Oh, well. What else do we have to do here? Contact lead scientist.
Hello.
This is Admiral Neertu. Just wanted to let you know your brother's safe and aboard our ship.
Thank you so much. Now, allow me to assist you. These access codes will wipe our computer core, destroying all of our data. No one will be able to replicate what we've done here without that information.
Alrighty then. Give me all your viruses. Alright, purge computer core. Enter access codes Upsilon Beta 241. I'm ready to beam up. Didn't look like there was anything around here to collect. So let's get out of Dodge, shall we? Sir, the Romulans are activating their assimilated ships. We have to destroy them. If we fire weapons at one of them, it will come online faster. But I think I can delay their activation if we get close enough to send a command sequence. Alright, target the nearest ship.
I want to thank you again for rescuing me from an unpleasant fate. If I could impose on you once more, would you be willing to take me to my colony? I must deliver a report on what's happened to our ruling council, and I'd really like to see my family again.
It would be our pleasure. Before we depart, let's grab this thing. So I have to explain... Oh, this freaking thing. So I have to explain what has happened here. I went back and I could not defeat this on advanced difficulty. So I had to go back and I went to normal difficulty and just redid the space scene because those three things at once it's not possible in the Defiant class ship that I have here anyway. So I had to go back and do it so that at normal mode so I could actually destroy one of those things before it became before it actually got online. And I remember this mission. I remember this is the one where I rage quit the first time this game and never came back to Star Trek Online. Was when I played this mission and just completely rage quit from it. That won't be the case this time around because I just persevered. But yeah, this is one of those that you just it makes you not want to continue because it is so BS. What they have set up there on the advanced difficulty, but I will continue here. Let us exit the system now, since there's nothing really here for us anymore, and I'll set it back to advanced difficulty once we get out of system here. I hope. Anyway, there we go. All right, so let's just really quickly set this back to advanced mode, which I forget. Forget where I do that. Let's collect our rewards. Oh, we gotta choose one. We'll say the Combat Hyper Impulse Engines, I think sounds good.
Congratulations, Admiral.
And I've gone up to level 45. Cool. And I got I'm now Rear Admiral Upper Half. So I've got a promotion from that.
Congratulations.
And I'll accept all that. We'll go back and do that soonish. Now, where is the... Jeez, everybody's popping up here. Shadow Play. Tequila. Tequila. The survivor you rescued from Demora Station has provided some very interesting information about both the Tal Shiar and the new race with which they've allied. Meanwhile, the Romulan Republic and neutral colonies are continuing to report mysterious abductions. We believe these two events are related. Tequila wants to go home to her colony on Serene Prime. The colony there has remained independent for both the remains of the Romulan Star Empire and the burgeoning Romulan Republic. That puts them in a delicate balancing act. We thought taking Tequila home would be a good opportunity to figure out what's happening behind the scenes of the Romulan conflict. We'd like you to go to Serene Prime and investigate. Alright, I will do that. I also wish to, if people stop interrupting me with things, I would like to set my difficulty again somewhere. I forget where I set that. Here it is. Let's put that back to advanced difficulty. Alright, for now. And ready to turn in new officer. We got new crew assignments. Okay, sure. Choose one of the following. All right, let's hail Starfleet, and we'll just grab the... I guess we'll take the Saurian Engineering Officer candidate, I suppose. Even though I don't have any more room on the ship right now. And we've got the Foregone Conclusions thing, too, to do, but I'd like to continue with the Romulan front here. Sounds like someone else just dinged around me. Anyway, purchase skills. Let's go. We got one ground skill as well. Let's go get something from these higher levels here. Like, say, damage control. Passively repaired over time. What is this? The scientific readiness. The shield mastery. Every several seconds, you will gain shield mastery. While this effect is active, the next critical hit you suffer will be completely negated, resulting in zero damage being dealt to you. This act will also consume the shield mastery until the next time it refreshes. Ooh. Interesting. Yeah, I'm going to take that, please and thank you. Oh, whoops, that's not what I want to do. I want to purchase that. Yes, purchase shield mastery. Thank you. And then what does that give me here? Starship perception doubles the benefit to stealth detection rating that you gain from auxiliary power or control resistance, provides additional 10% resistance incoming control effects. Yes. Given that we're up against the Romulans, let's get that. Yes, control resistance, cool. And then we have a ground point for first time in a while here. Armor master. Thickness of any combat armor you have equipped. Weapon penetration is probably good. Weapon experts. I think weapon penetration would be a good thing. So we'll purchase that, hopefully. And what does that give me here? Engineering training, bridge officer, unlock R&D recipe for an additional ground ability, training manual, combat supply 2, or support drone fabrication 2. Let's do the support drone fabrication 2, maybe. And get that going for us. Alrighty then. That seems to be working well. So far, so good. What's the status here on things? Do we have any injuries or anything? I don't think we do anymore. I think switching over to normal difficulty got rid of all the injuries and stuff that I had. So, anyway, where are we headed to? We are headed to the Serene Prime system, so let's head over that way now. And I will rejoin you folks once we arrive. Shadowplay! What the hell is that in front of me? Captain, we have arrived in the Serene system. This is supposed to be a neutral colony, but I'm detecting multiple Romulan Star Empire ships as well as a shield wall surrounding the planet. If this is a blockade, they're very serious about keeping people out. The warbirds are arming weapons, sir. We might have a fight if we want to return our guests to the colony. Speaking of which, Tequila would like a word. Patch her through.
I can't thank you enough for returning me. It looks like the Romulan Star Empire has been busy while I was away. They were already lobbying our council to join them, but Romulan Republic envoys are there as well. Now the Empire is blockading the planet, probably to prevent information like ours from reaching our leaders. The shield wall is new. I guess the Tal Shiar constructed it. You should be careful.
It isn't the first time we've run afoul of the Romulan Star Empire. Alright, it's not our first dance. Let's see what we can do about this. Hail the Romulan vessel. Which one would you like me to hail? I guess the one I'm coming up on, huh? Alright. Move forward here. Try and get into that green circle. Oh, this Romulan vessel. The IRW array. Alright, hail them.
This planet is protected by the Romulan Star Empire. State your business.
I didn't realize Srini Prime was a protectorate of the Romulan Star Empire.
Technically, it is not. However, the Empress has graciously extended her protection to all worlds in this region of space, including Srini Prime. There have been recent reports of terrorist activity on the planet. As a service to the lawful residents, we are securing the world against further intrusions.
Whether the Serenians like it or not, of course.
This planet is protected by the Romulan Star Empire. State your business.
I have come to trade.
Excellent. We welcome peaceful contacts with the Federation. I assume you will agree to submit to a routine search for contraband. Lower your shields and prepare to be boarded.
I don't think so. Well, I eventually defeated the Romulan, but I had to go back onto normal mode, and even in normal mode, it really sucked. Like, it was not easy there either. I've died at least 20 times or so. So that's why I've cut out most of that stuff, because it's just me repeatedly dying over and over and over again. But there you have it. So we've gotten through the we've gotten through the blockade one way or the other here. Now we have to see what is next on us. And yes, I've gone back to normal mode because I could not do it. Let's go grab this real fast while we're here, before we head down to the surface, and then we'll see what else is in store here. So this is the part that pains me a bit, is that it feels like I can't use the Defiant anymore going forward. Like, I'm gonna have to go up to the next ship type, which sucks because I really like the Defiant, but I guess, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do.
I can't believe I finally made it home. Thank you. I never thought I'd see this place again. I would give you the grand tour such as it is, but I need to get back to my family. I never thought I'd see them again either. You should talk to a representative from our council. Follow the path ahead and it will lead you to our central square. There should be someone you can speak with there.
Welcome home. Alright, move on forward down the pathway here. Hello, hello, hello. Anybody? Just follow her to wherever she's going. I can run ahead of you. You're not running fast enough for being home. Ooh, hello. What is this loot box over here? I must see you. Yeah, I'll take all that. Sure. You're just gonna leave it out there? I'm gonna take it. Why not? So where do we go now? I guess we go right here, huh? Walk right through all these centurions and speak to the counselor.
Jolan Tru, and welcome to Srini Prime. Oh, thank you for returning Takela to us. I'm sure her family is pleased she is safe. However, you have arrived at an interesting time. I was just preparing to meet with representatives from the Romulan Star Empire and the Romulan Republic. Each are urging our colony to join their faction. We've done our best to stay out of the conflict until now, but I fear we will soon be forced to take a side.
Yes, we met one of the Empire's representatives in orbit. They tried to destroy my ship, and now they're dead because of it.
Yes, the Empire has a way of offering assistance that feels more like a threat. They offered security services for my world, and I could not risk refusing them. And, to be fair, there have been no abductions since the fleet began. protecting the planet.
Abductions?
A number of our citizens went missing in the weeks before the Empire arrived. The Empire blames the Republic, of course, but I think Sela likes to blame them for a lot of things. There's no evidence they are responsible, however. In fact, there's no evidence at all. And I think that if the Republic were behind these kidnappings, they would leave some trace behind. If you would care to speak to the representatives, I would be interested in hearing what your opinion of them is.
I am honored by your request, Counselor. Well, I know who I'm going to pick right away without even talking to them, but anyway, let's talk to them. Let's give them an audience.
You are not welcome here, Starfleet.
The Counselor feels differently. She asked me to speak with you to give her my opinion.
Then she is a fool. The Federation are allies of the terrorists who seek to destroy what remains of our glorious empire. You will do nothing here but sow dissent and unrest. I also know that you destroyed a ship protecting this planet, with callous disregard for the safety of the citizens of this colony. I have nothing more to say to a murderer.
Yeah, well, he left me no choice.
You had no choice? Those words have been the excuse of monsters since time immemorial. On the chance, however, that the Council is foolish enough to be swayed by your biased opinion, I will explain that the Romulan Star Empire is Serene Prime's only hope for peace and stability. We alone possess the military strength and operational effectiveness to keep this planet safe. The terrorists from the Republic can only offer them a portion of their own loss and suffering. The Empress has already sent ships to defend this colony. That is evidence of our intentions.
Your intentions are clear, Subcommander. I think I've heard enough. Yeah, where's the other representative at? Up, over there, okay. Over here and talk to her.
A pleasure to meet you. What can I do for you?
What is your mission here?
My intent was to speak to the Council about the advantages of joining the Republic. Fortunately, I arrived before the blockade, and the Council has extended their protection to me. Otherwise, I'd probably be on my way to one of the Tal Shiar's prison facilities by now. The Empress likes to hide her threats in a few layers of deception and lies. It can be difficult for a peaceful world like Serene Prime to resist. But if we all stick together, we will be able to rise up and defeat the Tal Shiar once and for all.
Hear, hear. You have ambitious goals, Subcommander. Good luck. Alright. So, yeah, that was pretty much a no-brainer. Talk to her again.
Well, what did you think of them?
Should they stay neutral? Yep, I may be biased, but I think you should join the Republic.
An interesting perspective. Thank you for your suggestion. Our most convincing evidence comes from a survivor of Virenat. And if his story can be believed, he says he knows who is behind these abductions. You should speak to him before you leave. He's behind that building.
I'll listen to this guy. I already know who's behind the abductions, honestly. We've seen them. We've seen them with our own eyes. We've returned one, as it was, but I still, you know, apparently the Hirogen has something to do with all this thing too, so, you know, we'll see who shakes out at the end.
Yes, I was at Virenat. My family died there. My friends. It wasn't terrorists who destroyed my home, and it certainly wasn't the Republic. It was the Tal Shiar and their friends. But you don't have to take my word for it. Virenat has been abandoned since the attack. Go see what our Empress does to her people.
Well, I'm sorry for your loss. Travel to Virenat to investigate the truth behind the destruction of the colony. Sure. We'll do that. Let's do that now. There we go. It appears we've done all we can here, sir. Shall we return to the ship? Yep. Yep, we should. Sir, course locked in for Virenat. However, there are Romulan ships decloaking. They're hailing us, Captain. On screen.
You are wanted for crimes against the Romulan Star Empire. Lower your shields and prepare to be boarded.
You lower your shields and prepare to be boarded. Sir, there's a Romulan Republic vessel here as well. They're hailing us. On screen?
You appear to be having some difficulties with the Tal Shiar. Please, allow us to assist. This is the least we can do for our allies in Starfleet.
Glad to have the help, Commander. Okay. So, let's do our thing here. Alright, well, we destroyed each other. Note to self, just put your nose all on their butts and just be destroyed by them, and that usually does it.
Will no longer trouble you. Do you require anything else?
No, thank you for your assistance, dead guy. I love that. We cross the shield barrier and exit the system before Tal Shiar reinforcements arrive. Sure, agreed. This has been just a cavalcade of failure, let me tell you, folks. So I have a lot of just finding new, improved weapons to do. We have arrived in the Viranet system. Sensors are detecting no signs of activity in the system, not even satellites. For a once populated world, the sensor silence is eerie. Alright, set a course for the planet. It's all cloaked. The entire planet is cloaked. Or there's tons of debris, as the case may be. Scan that debris. What is that? Piece of a ship? Sir, this debris appears to be from a Romulan vessel. It's old, but it took some heavy energy weapon hits before it was destroyed. You don't normally see battles like this near agricultural colonies. Yeah, you don't. So everyone has been... They were bombarded from orbit, I guess. So let's come into that. We got some more debris over here. Needs our attention. Scan it. Sir, this appears to be debris from a vessel of unknown configuration. However, the energy signatures conform to the limited information we have about the Alachi. There's not enough here for the ship to have been destroyed, sir. Whatever it was, it probably survived this battle. This could be the mysterious enemy the survivors talk about. Could it be the Alachi? We need more information. Yeah, it probably is. All right, now which way you want me to go? Oh, you want me to go towards the plant now? Okay, happily, let's spin right around and see where we go. Might as well clear off some of this. Oh, or not. Sir, I'm detecting a vessel. Wait, there's nothing there. Must have been a sensor echo. No, it's a cloaked vessel. Of course, you know it's not, there's no such thing as sensor echoes. Are you ready to beam the surface, sir? Transport to the planet's surface. Sure, I guess. This place is destroyed, Captain, but the damage is only a few months old. I'm not detecting any humanoid life signs. However, there are several intact life forms around the area. We should be cautious. Acknowledged? You mean like that giant bug that just walked by? Great. We're bug fighting right now. System with Romulan Starship design specifications. Retrieve a sample for analysis. Alright, and I guess we gotta take these things on, huh? Sure, we'll just destroy these before they destroy us. Just want to be absolutely certain. Kill it before it kills you. And there's got to be more coming up here. I just see a lot of red dots on my screen. Battle here must have been massive. Yeah, it must have. Alright, so I guess we go this way towards all the bugs. Alright, let's just get their attention and get this show on the road here. Go. Nice. Alright, they're down for the count. And where is the thing that we need to look at here? No, I'm like right on top of it. I guess it's that body on the ground there. That looks like it might be an Alachi, possibly. Okay, good. Very good. What is this? Scan colonist. Sir, although this colonist died of plasma weapons discharge, her tissues appear to be infected with some kind of fungal spores. The bio readings I'm getting are somewhat similar to some of the readings from the prisoners on Installation 18. The evidence of Alachi involvement is mounting. Take a sample. Okay. So we scan them. They're having some kind of festival when they were attacked. Not during the festival. Not during the festival of peace and tranquility. They were attacked. They were attacked from orbit. I think this device is some kind of beacon, but it doesn't conform to any technology I'm familiar with. However, the components seem to match some of the equipment we discovered on Installation 18. Get a full scan. Starfleet will want to review our findings. So collect evidence. Okay, and then we got one more place to visit, and some more bugs to squash, I imagine, along the way. Not that way. So we gotta go all the way back the way we came and around here. Looks like this crater was created by an orbital strike from a plasma weapon of Romulan origin. Since it is doubtful the colony destroyed themselves, it could have only been the Tal Shiar. Sir, I'm detecting a subspace transmission. We can access it at the console over there. Okay, sure. We're going to use their equipment that's still apparently working. I guess, no, that was to get me to come over here and kill more of these things, right? That's basically what that was for. Hey, we made these bugs. We need you to kill all of them. Oh, this console? Wow, that was pretty well hidden. Welcome, guest. You have one message from Empress Sela. Would you like to play it now? Sure, I guess.
Citizens of the Empire, it is with great sorrow that I report the destruction of our colony in the Virenat system by the terrorist insurgents known as the Romulan Republic. I believe most of the residents of Virenat were loyal subjects of the Empire who were unaware of the terrorist cell hidden amongst their homes and families. Their deaths are a tragedy. When the Tal Shiar attempted to remove the insurrectionists and save Virenat and its people, the Romulan Republic destroyed the entire colony rather than submit to the lawful authority of my forces. I grieve for the loss of innocent life. Rest assured that those responsible will be found and punished for their crimes against the Romulan people. Virenat will not be forgotten.
I'm getting some unusual energy readings, similar to the ones we received from that strange beacon. Oh, great. People have beamed down. Oh, Eaglelith drones? What the freak are these things? Well, that was a thing. Let me go pick this up. Take items. Just a small shield charge, huh? That's it. Captain, a ship from an unknown configuration has decloaked and is arming weapons. Recommend you take the away team beam up immediately. All right. Well, I guess we're going to find the Alachi now. And their robotic drones, I guess. It was a scout ship, Captain. We drove it off, but I'm expecting reinforcements any moment. Acknowledged. All right, let's get moving here. Qualish frigate. All right. Sagoth escort. Yeah, these look like Alachi, probably. Look at these freaking weapons they're shooting me with. Holy hell. Alright, that's one down. And my heavy phaser beam turret's doing some work here. We got another one. Need to worry about. Another Alachi vessel. And let's get see if we can get their shields down, shall we? Alright, yeah, doing some good work here, I'd say. Yeah, we almost got him. Done. turret comes in handy sometimes. When it doesn't get destroyed right away, it comes in handy. Captain, we're receiving a priority subspace transmission from Starfleet Command. Do you want me to put it on the main view screen? On screen.
To all Starfleet vessels, our allies in the Romulan Republic are under attack by the Tal Shiar. All combat-ready vessels are ordered to report to New Romulus immediately. Individual orders to follow.
Open a channel to Admiral Tenet.
Thank you for responding so quickly. Your orders are to rendezvous with Battle Group Phi at Virinat and proceed to New Romulus to reinforce our vessels there. The battle is already underway.
We're on our way, Admiral. All right, rendezvous with Battle Group. In 3 seconds, apparently.
Glad to have you here. Let's get to New Romulus.
Looks like they're rendezvousing with me. Alright, warp to New Romulus. Let's do this. Might as well do it now, while we can. Got nothing else to do right now.
We are grateful beyond words for your help. You have arrived in the nick of time. New Romulus does not have the developed orbital defenses necessary to repel such an attack, and Admiral Kararek is calling for as many ships as possible to defend the planet. The flotilla protecting the planet has been pushed back by the enemy assault. They are at their final line now. They need your help.
Battle stations.
Glad you could join us. Concentrate fire on their command ship.
Okay, which one is their command ship? Wow, that's a lot of Alachi vessels. I assume their command ship will have a name that I can see somewhere. I guess we better get in there a little bit. Oh, there's the command ship. Okay. Alright, this guy is the command ship, so I will do as they say and just focus my fire on that puppy. As much as I can, anyway. And he's hitting us with something here. I don't know what it is, but I don't like it. Don't like it at all. Alright, come on, we can do this. Just gotta stay put and keep hitting all the torpedoes all the time here. Alright. They're in the thick of things now. Wow, I just took a freaking hit and a half here. Alright, that just got destroyed. Let's get out of dodge. Oh, they got me. Alright, well, at least we took their command ship down with us. And the rest should be relatively easy to clean up, I would imagine here. Alright, respawn me. Where are we at? Way the hell over here, huh? We got a battleship here, though, that is all by its lonesome, so maybe I can help out by taking that out. Our play complete. That's good to know. And some more torpedoes. Someone say they want more torpedoes. Here's some more torpedoes for you. Alright, let's get out of that before that we get killed by that again. There we go. Very good. So, we're being hailed by the Romulan Republic. On screen.
On behalf of the Romulan Republic, thank you for your assistance today. You have saved our new world from destruction. We cannot begin to repay these deeds you have performed today. We know that your names will go down in history.
Sorry, I can't hear you over the sound of my awesomeness here. Sounds like we're done here. Not quite yet. There's a few Romulans left here or a few Alachi left that I wish to give a bloody nose to. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Hello, everybody. Cool. Ooh, USS Akagi. Looking spiffy there. IKS Kang, we got some of the Klingon fleet here too. Sweet. Okay, so that's done. I'm sure someone's gonna contact me soon here. Yep. The Romulan Republic extends their sincere gratitude for your assistance in saving their homeworld. We now know the race you encountered there is called the Alachi, and they are the Tal Shiar's new allies. From what you found on Virinat and what they tried to do at New Romulus, I'd say that whatever they're doing, it's not in our best interests. Republic is continuing to search for clues to reveal what exactly is happening to the people being abducted by the Alachi. You, however, may be set to a different task. Alright, plasma beam array, dual plasma beam bank, dual plasma heavy, plasma dual heavy cannons, plasma torpedo launcher. Let's try the heavy cannons, maybe. See how that works. And she's got new missions for me, Taris. How much do you know about the destruction of Romulus, Admiral? The initial explosion did not occur in the Romulus system, it was in the Hobus system, which had planets being mined for decalithium. The supernova acted counter to almost all we know about this type of phenomena. The initial explosion converted the mass of the planets it consumed into energy, which then traveled through subspace. Ultimately, the Romulus system was destroyed, and along with it, the Romulan homeworld. Unchecked, the force of this chain reaction detonation could have threatened the entire quadrant. It was Ambassador Spock who sealed the rift by using red matter to create an artificial black hole. Until recently, the cause of the supernova was a mystery. However, the nascent Romulan Republic, our new ally, has shared information with us that Taris, former praetor of the Romulan Star Empire, may have been responsible for the Hobus supernova. They attempted to apprehend her, but she escaped through an Iconian gateway. Recently, the Romulan Republic has discovered new information that could help us track down Taris. We want you to rendezvous with the RRW Lacette, the new flagship of the Romulan Republic fleet, and provide any assistance you can. Awesome. So we're here in the story of the destruction of Romulus yet again, and of course, they're bringing the Iconians back into it, which was a race from, I think, season one of The Next Generation, where they had the jumping through Iconian gateways, an ancient race that no longer existed, or in this timeline anyway. And I just wanted to these things that are completed. Let's get our success rewards here. Excellent. All those things are done. So before we go any further, let us go back to Seoul and accept our promotion. And also, I am going to have to bite the bullet and get in a bigger ship. I already have a bigger ship, I think, sitting around waiting for me. I just really like the Defiant, and it's unfortunate that I can't sit here and play with the Defiant any longer, because I think it's showing its age now, given that I can't get through a mission without dying about 15 times. So, in the meantime, we do have a space point. So I think hull penetration, that's pretty good. Shield weakening. Prevent. By default, most enemy starship shields will prevent 90% of the damage dealt by your weapons from reaching the hull. Apply this damage instead to the shields. For each point of shield weakening skill, the resulting damage applied to shields will be increased by 0.1%. Note that damage applied to shields from most mines and torpedoes will then be reduced by 75% due to innate shield resistance to kinetic damage. Shield weakening. That sounds rather fantastic, actually. But what's this one? Improved weapon specialization. Critical chance bonus goes up a bit. This one, improved weapon amplification. The critical severity goes up a lot. Shield hardness. Let's get something for our weapons. Let's do the weapon amplification, I think. Let's try that and see how that works out for me. Alrighty then. And we are proceeding to Seoul system. So I will return with you folks once we get onto the space station. Congratulations, Admiral. You have conquered yet another milestone on your journey through Starfleet. You still have challenges ahead of you, but I am confident you'll be able to do anything you set out to do. Good luck. All right, cool. So we got another respect token. Excellent. And we got our promotion. And I believe if we go, I don't know if we get another ship or not since we're still an Admiral, but we'll see here. Let's go take a look and see if they gave me access to something else. We do have a Sovereign class ship that we got last time I did have access to things. So let's come up here and do Starship and Shuttle Requisitions. Let's see what we've got here. We want to do Rear Admiral. I guess I don't get one until I get to Vice Admiral. I think that's what that's telling me there. Yeah, I don't have any respect tokens. Okay, so we do have a Sovereign already, Assault Cruiser. So I guess I should make that my I should make that my default ship, which I always forget who does that. Is it over here? Yeah, select your ship. And we will select the Cortex 5. And I'll start transferring some... what is this? The Sea Mist was that one. Okay. Yeah, we'll go over to this one, and we will start transferring things over to it. Oh, actually, it automatically transfers things over. That's good. I am glad it did that. And what else do I have? I think I have some more tactical consoles and stuff here, if I'm not mistaken. I know I have more devices. Let's see. This everything's in my way here. All right. Science consoles, engineering consoles. What else do we have? We have a covariant shield array, which is not as good as the Varitrinic shield array that I have on there. That's interesting. Okay. This is a quantum torpedo launcher, which is not even worth the effort. All right. Just keeping track of everything. This one is better. This one is even better. This is the Hyper Impulse Engines Mark 10, right? With speed. So I should probably put those on there. That would be a good thing. So we'll do that. And I like these turrets, these heavy phaser satellite turret things. So I'd like to... I have 11 more of them. It's just that the cooldown on them is so freaking long. It's the only real problem there. And this is the warp core. We have a better warp core on there. The piercing dual tetrion beam bank is, what is that, 214? Oh yeah, that's a heck of a lot better than the Kelvin timeline phaser emitter I have on the aft weapon. But this is the current forward weapon is that one, 214. This is, oh, it's only 151. Oh, I'm looking at the wrong thing here. Okay, never mind. That's not any good. I should probably start selling some things that aren't useful for me. And actually maybe buy some things too. That would be a trick. A trick and a half here. Tetrion cannon. Dual Tetrion banks. This one does 192 DPS. And my forward weapon is... Phaser beam array. Okay, well, this is better than the phaser beam array, most definitely. Although, is this one? That's Mark 9, Mark 10. Let's put this one up here. So we get even more power up front. And our torpedoes appear to be... Yeah, forward weapon is Kelvin timeline photon torpedo. 623 DPS. So I think we're... good in that respect of the term. And then what is this? This is the deteriorating secondary deflector. I don't have anything yet that takes a secondary deflector, and I have so many of these things lying around, and I don't have the means of using them, because there's no secondary deflectors on this. And then what is this? This is the cannon I just got, right? Plasma dual heavy cannons. Does that... I think that goes on here? Does that... This is an assault cruiser. Does it go on the assault cruiser? It doesn't look like it has the ability to be on an assault cruiser. No, it does not. Okay, well, that's a bit of a waste. That's unfortunate. And all those things, but oh well. And what is this? The shield array... 6171, that's not quite as good, and 5747, wow. Nothing's matching anything here, as far as that is concerned. And everything else is... So the aft weapon is a worse photon torpedo launcher than ones I have here, so I might as well grab one of these. What is this one? This is a even worse shield array. Okay, let's grab this guy. Put him on the aft weapons, at least for that one anyway. Replace that one that's there. So that should work for me now, right? 407 and yeah, it's just the aft weapon or two photon torpedoes. What is this, 356? Yeah, that's, you would think that would be more, but it's not. I mean, it has other effects on it though. And I think that's about it here for all that. Do I want another phaser on the back? We got a, what is this? This is a 8 Kelvin timeline. This is 143. This is 152. What is this? 151. What was this one? 143 was this? All right, well, this one's better than that, so we'll put that there. Okay. Getting all the DPS I can. That's about it, I think, as far as Starship equipment goes. So hopefully we'll be in a better position now to actually wreck some faces instead of getting completely decimated as I have been up to this point. I guess I should put some devices in there while we have them. And don't let your device sections go unused anyway. Actually, I should probably put the shield thing in there. I use that more than I would use the other one. The auxiliary power one. Okay, cool. Well, I think that will just about do it for this episode of Star Trek Online. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. And I will see you next time.